This is a special report on the Hyperion shuttle mission launched last week aboard a Saturn C3X rocket. The mission had Guzman Kerman and Shelby Kerman on board. This was the first crewed mission of the Hyperion shuttle. It was also the first mission that would leave Earth orbit and would fly by the moon and then return to Earth orbit using its booster pack. So you see here a simulated view of the Hyperion shuttle as it left the vicinity of the Earth. It conducted its burn shortly after launch, roughly an hour and a half after launch. That TLI burn sending Guzman Kerman and Shelby Kerman on their way to the moon. The Hyperion shuttle, of course, has accommodations for 6 Kerbals in total and has supplies for more than 100 days worth of stay aboard the shuttle for those 6 Kerbals, so more than 300 days worth of supplies for just 2. That, of course, is important because on this test, we want to make sure that at no stage is anything rushed, so that the Kerbals, if necessary, can stay in orbit and be rescued, or some other way of bringing them back can be found. The Hyperion shuttle entered the moon's sphere of influence 2 days and 20 hours after launch, and was scheduled to hit periapsis 3 days and 14 hours after launch. Of course, if this mission is successful, it means that the Hyperion shuttle could be used to transport up to 6 Kerbals to a lunar base, a lunar orbital facility, and then also bring that personnel back safely. So it is a critical mission and would certainly demonstrate an unprecedented access to the moon thanks to the efforts of the EDB. On approaching the moon, the shuttle did a few maneuvers, primarily one using RCS to adjust its orbit to actually pull it further away from the moon, but that was designed to minimize the burn that would be necessary at periapsis to fix its orbit for the return. The goal, of course, was to ensure that the return orbit would hit the atmosphere of the Earth at the right altitude for re-entry. Not full re-entry, though, for aerocapture, because the shuttle will be capturing into orbit rather than re-entering directly. So here you see the continued simulation as the Hyperion shuttle approached the moon. After the adjustment, the expected periapsis was approximately 2,000 kilometers away from the lunar surface, so quite a high orbit around the moon, but better to be safe and bring them back rather than risk a closer encounter with the moon. As the periapsis burn point approached, we got an in-cockpit view of the Kerbals as they prepared for the burn. They chose to use their RL-10 engine on the booster pack instead of the RCS. There is a prodigious amount of RCS fuel on the Hyperion shuttle, probably more than 1,000 meters per second, though it hasn't been accurately calculated at this point because of the shift from hydrazine to MMH plus N2O4. But the shuttle has a substantial amount of RCS fuel, but they decided to use the booster pack because the liquid hydrogen was boiling off, and so better to use the fuel there quickly. Unfortunately, while they did use the RCS to settle down the fuel, the RL-10 misfired, and for some reason it was accidentally staged on an attempt to fire it again. It did have multiple relights, but on the attempt to fire it again, they accidentally decoupled it. And so the burn had to be done with the RCS fuel, leaving the shuttle with much less RCS fuel for stability during re-entry, as well as to rendezvous with Titan Station as planned. So this is a serious situation now. But the Kerbals conducted it well. Guzman and Shelby remained calm during the whole discussion with Mission Control about what to do. That is the particular approach to Earth that they would take, as they had to decide whether they would continue on for Titan Station or simply attempt to get into orbit, in some orbit, any orbit. And it was decided that they would continue on for Titan Station, and that the shuttle would make multiple aerobraking passes through the atmosphere, thereby saving some of the RCS fuel that would have been necessary if they tried to aim for a lower altitude and simply get into a tight orbit on the first pass. So that is the current plan for the Hyperion shuttle. Some things that the designers are reviewing is the use of a decoupler with the boost pack instead of a docking port. Of course, the decoupler was attached to the docking port on the shuttle's tail, but it could be possible simply to use another docking port to dock the booster pack, and that would have other beneficial effects, so that might be a plan. Initially, the decoupler was used because there was a controller device on the tail for the unmanned mission, but that's no longer necessary, and there is in fact an unmanned controller in the cargo bay this time. So with that being fixed, perhaps that will be a resolution that will ensure that it doesn't accidentally decouple in the future. But for now, we will have to wait to see what occurs with Guzming and Shelby. You see here a small RCS burn that they did to ensure that they were at the same inclination as Titan Station on their approach to Earth. So they were matching inclinations there. But yes, we hope all the best for Guzming and Shelby as they make their return to Earth orbit, tighter Earth orbit, of course, and hope they do make their rendezvous with Titan Station. We should be able to bring a report on that on Friday. Assuming there aren't too many aerobraking passes, they should be done with their braking by then. So thank you for watching, and we hope you enjoy this report. And this is the EDB signing off.